This weekend sees us arrive in Shanghai for the Chinese Grand Prix. First up is today's practice session. Welcome then to all our viewers and of course to Anthony Davidson as well. Now Ant, I wanted to ask you, obviously there's a lot of hard work involved in these sessions, a lot of simulations as well. Is this something the drivers enjoy or is it just a routine that becomes a chore?
There's nothing routine about driving a Formula One car, I can tell you that. 300 kilometers per hour down the straights, 4G through the corners. It's hard to ignore those forces acting on your body. It's lap after lap of hard, exhausting work. You always enjoy driving these cars. It's a real privilege. Although I must say, if you're having a day where you can't get the car to do what you want and it's generally underperforming, then it's a lot harder to stay motivated. But never a chore, no. Even if you're having a tough start to the weekend, at this point you know that if you work hard at it, there's still an opportunity to turn things around.
Great workout there today. How do you think it went? You really went all out in practice today. Are you testing new components? It's the start of the season. How do you think things are going to go for you? Great! Well, that's everything.
We'd like to welcome you from wherever in the world you join us today for this F1 qualifying session here in Shanghai, China.
We've seen in the past how tricky the first corner is. It's not an issue in practice and qualifying, but if you throw a lot of highly competitive drivers at it all at once, you've got an entirely different situation. The smarter drivers will be able to temper their approach and stay out of trouble, but it doesn't mean it's easy.
Everyone ready? Okay, let's go. in second place.
Good day today. Tell us about it from your perspective. Are you happy with where you'll be on the grid tomorrow? We've not seen much development progression for your car recently. Why is that? Great. Well, that's everything.
Well done. That was a good qualifying performance.
Ever since the Sauber of Felipe Massa passed Jenson Button into Turn 1 at the very first Chinese Grand Prix in 2004, Shanghai has consistently provided close racing and extraordinary memories. It's where Lewis Hamilton effectively lost the title in his rookie year, and it's where Nico Rosberg claimed Mercedes' first win of the modern era in 2012. Shanghai International Circuit then, a 16-corner high-speed thrill ride. The long and ever-tightening right-hander at turns 1 and 2 tests a driver's patience, and the flat, open to the element's location, tests their skill in a crosswind. Two DRS zones will assist passing, and overtaking is available into turn 1, and of course down the kilometre-long back straight into the hairpin at turn 14. Joining me once again to take you through this race is the effervescent Anthony Davidson, and I'm very much looking forward to it getting underway. You raced here, of course, didn't you, back in your Super Aguri days in that infamous Chinese Grand Prix of 2007?
Yeah, that's right. I didn't last that long though, unfortunately. Qualifying had gone pretty well, but my brakes failed quite early in the race, around lap 10 or 11, something like that. And of course, back in 2004, I was the very first Formula One driver to complete a lap of this circuit. Just thought I'd mention that for you, Crofty, like a good stat. It's a fairly tough circuit on the brakes here though, you know, it's that long back straight down into turn 14, and then you got turns 6 and 11, they're quite heavy as well. On top of that, managing your front tyre wear is always a challenge around here, so there's a lot to keep in mind during the Grand Prix.
We're almost ready to go then, and this is what the starting grid looks like for today's race. Lewis Hamilton lines up on pole position, with Sebastian Vettel starting alongside. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Raikkonen, Ricciardo, Valtteri Bottas, and Alonso, Hülkenberg, Grosjean, Magnussen, and Stoffel Van Dorn, Perez, Ocon, Carlos Sainz, Scott, Verstappen, Leclerc, Brendan Hartley, and Lance Stroll, Sirotkin, and Pierre Gasly rounds off the grid. Now it's almost time to lights out, so let's go down to the track.
You're above where we expected on the grid. Be careful not to lose places, as there will be faster cars around you. Cycle, so let's concentrate on bringing tyres and brakes up to temperature.
Mm-hmm.
the ERS deployment mode to prevent this. DRS is now enabled. Will be available to use when you are within 1 second of the car ahead in the DRS zone. probably expect you're going to start feeling the effect of tyre wear around about now. Let us know if it gets too bad. We're approaching the pit window. You'll be on the mediums.
Be careful out there.
rainfall to worsen soon. Heavy rain predicted in 5 minutes' time. Safety car in this lap. Safety car in this lap. Let's make sure those tyres are up to temperature, and remember there is no overtaking until the first safety car line. Stay in position until the green flags.
Sauber team today. So Ant, how exactly did they set themselves apart from the pack today?
Well, keeping their tyre temperatures up in the tricky wet conditions was really important. There's not much grip out there at the best of times, and it's 10 times worse if you're out there on cold tyres. So the way they kept the rubber in its proper operating window was a huge advantage today.
So, here they come out now onto the podium after a thrilling Grand Prix. It just goes to show what a strong position the sport is in, that these independent teams can be so competitive. What a superb victory from the Sauber team. And now let's take a look at the driver's standings. It's a good result for Sebastian Vettel, who moves further ahead at the top of the table. Moving on to the driver of the day then, Anthony Davidson, who would you go for?
I have to give it to Scott. They demonstrated a very delicate touch in close proximity to other cars, as well as showing a lot of maturity and patience in difficult situations.
And now let's take a look at the constructors' standings. Ferrari extend their lead at the top of the championship. There was also a strong showing from the Mercedes team today as they make their way up the standings. After all this drama, you'd be mad not to join us for the next race. We hope to see you then. Take care.
Amazing performance out there. You must be really happy.
You're breaking all expectations. What's your secret?
You took the top points today. Was it a comfortable win? Well, looks like your luck has changed. Things went a lot better than last weekend, didn't they? You were cutting your way through the field during the race. Appreciate your time.
Fantastic podium. Well done. Keep pushing like this for the rest of the season. Here you can see a list of eligible drivers to declare as your rival. The more challenging they are to beat, the more the paddock will respect you for succeeding. Just be aware, you'll lose the same amount of respect if you come off second best. So it may be wise not to be overly ambitious.